Greetings. So this time I'd like to talk about 2 Samuel chapter 16 verses 7 and 8. And thus said Shimei when he cursed, come out, thou bloody man, and thou man of Belial. The Lord hath returned upon thee all the blood of the house of Saul, in whose stead thou hast reigned. And the Lord hath delivered the kingdom into the hand of Absalom thy son, and behold, thou art taken in thy mischief, because thou art a bloody man. So to give you some context here, this man Shimei is cursing David. And so David and his army is fleeing Jerusalem because, Absalom, his oldest son, it should be his oldest son, basically took over the kingdom. He did a coup and he's trying to kill his dad. Definitely not the best situation to be in for David. And so here, to add salt on his wounds, Shimei's saying, well, that's what you deserve. He's saying, God is punishing you for your sins. So, and there will be people like that. There will be sometimes, when someone in a position of authority or not even necessarily authority has issues in life and they struggle, then there might be someone, some stupid person out there that says, oh, that's just God punishing you for your sins. And I'm like, how do you know that? Like, there's no way. Like, when people go through trouble, it's not necessarily, oh, God's punishing you for your sins. I mean, I would never take responsibility or authority to assume that someone has done a lot of things wrong because they're going through troubles in life. That, that's just God punishing them for the wickedness of their ways. No, unless I personally know that person and I know that they did something bad, like literally physically, I know they did something bad to get into that situation. Unless I have all that information, I am never going to. I'm not just going to assume something like that, and you shouldn't either. Because when you start doing that, guess what? You might be next. God might do the same to you. So I would be really careful about how I judge people, and assuming things about people's lives and their circumstances. I'd be very, very careful about that. This is one of those enemies. This is one of David's enemies who is cursing him, saying, that's what you deserve. And then, if you read the passage further down, David at this time is in the right spirit, and he said, and some of his soldiers, his commanders, are like, hey, like I'll just walk over there and I'll just chop that guy's head off. You don't have to keep listening to this. And David says, no, just calm down. Like, it's fine. This man is sent from God to test me. Let him curse. Maybe God will bless me in the future. So that's what David goes on. So right now, David's in the right spirit. And that's really the best way to handle this is if you start, if you start getting aggressive with these people, your enemies, that talk trash about you, then you'll just be on their level. So if at all possible, you wanna avoid that. If you do have someone like that in your life, that just a constant thorn in your side, the best you can do is just like not hang out with these people. I mean, unfortunately, sometimes people like this could be your relatives. Sometimes they're your friends. Now, if they're your friends, then at that point they're not your friends anymore, basically. So, but when they're relatives, that's a lot harder because you can't always completely, disassociate yourself from relatives. It just, unfortunately, that's just life. But if possible, if you have these kind of toxic, negative people in your life, you do obviously want to avoid them, whoever they might be. You want to avoid them, but just know that, but you don't necessarily want to repay evil for evil though. So that can happen. So just because someone's struggling and has difficulties in their life doesn't mean they did something wrong. could just be a trial from God. It's not necessarily that they did something wrong. And, you know, as I've said before, I'd be very careful about assuming that. Some of the most toxic people I know are people that gossip and that act like this. This is worse than being an alcoholic. I'd rather hang out with a Christian that has a drinking problem than people that act like this. So the alcoholic might actually have a better relationship than God, with God, than someone that acts like this and calls themselves a Christian. So this is the kind of stuff that splits churches. I have seen church splits, and it's always pride, arrogance, this kind of behavior, gossiping, stuff that does not belong in a church at all. So anyway, so I just thought this would be I just saw this passage, thought it was a really good one, decided to make a video. Anyway, so I'll try to post daily. So yeah, stay tuned. See you next time.